fight happens.
I'd rather match them against either one of them before they fight each other. I'd like to see Zab fight absolutely everybody in that division, because I think he will take absolutely every one of them to school. And I think we saw a little bit tonight what we're going to see. You know, obviously he has a few more things to work on. He probably got hit more than I would like to see, but as I said, Fernell's only had 6 weeks. I can't wait to see what he looks like in 6 months, and that's really what I'm looking forward to.
I'm going to ask Zab the same question that they're going to ask people. Yesterday he made 138 look pretty much easy. Is it stretching it to consider him coming down at 135?
You know,
where he can make a lot of noise in that division?
It's clearly entered my mind too, but you're going to ask me that. I mean, obvious, one thing that's clear is that when he was fighting at welterweight, he was fighting way up. And I don't think anybody ever really took that into consideration. He should have been in this division, or perhaps lightweight, all this time. If he's at 138 now, he should have been at 135 10 years ago. And looking, you know, shit away, he can't change things. But it's obvious that he's been up in that ring fighting people that are coming down from 160 and still getting them. Most of them have fought in their lives. So. I'd like to see him against a lot of people. Amir Khan's, Bradley's, Devin Alexander, Marquez, which is to me a very interesting fight. And I would love to see him on pay-per-view, because I really think that that 24/7 or whatever Showtime's calling it now, with him working with Pernell Whitaker, Showtime's got their own too, him working with Whitaker, it's a beautiful story. The tapes of Whitaker fighting, I'd love to be the producer cutting that up. I mean, it's a beautiful story. You've got Zab's family, and that is another story, and you can put it all together, and it's terrific. Also, Manny Pacquiao, that's all the other ones. We'll go fight him. Listen to me, I don't have to do it.
You guys can do that in the new Giants Stadium, huh?
I like that. Okay. I think we should bring Kaizer up here because he's here now, and let's bring him up and have him speak to you.
I'm glad to be given a chance that I fought a big guy like Zab Judah. I think I was controlling the fight. No matter, I caught him, but I didn't have a finisher. Just caught me with a nice uppercut. But then, that's the fight. I would like to come again if they offer me a rematch. He had his chance. I had a chance to knock him out, but I didn't finish. I think he had a lot of experience. I think he used his experience against his fight. So I'd like to come again if they give me opportunity to fight in America. That was a very good point. Thank you very much.
Congratulations, first of all, on a great fight. You fought really well in this fight. Sixth round, you hurt Zab. Walk us through, at the end of the sixth round, you went back to your corner. Seventh round begins. What was going through your mind? Were you thinking, let me get Zab out of here? What were you thinking?
No, that's what I'm saying. Like, I didn't have the finish up. Like, I wanted to finish up, but he used his experience, because he had a lot of experience. And so I think I've tried to knock him out, but I saw that if I can just fall on these punches, he'll knock me out. So I tried to, because he was coming down, I tried to knock the boat, but you know, he had a lot of experience. So I'd like to fight him again, because I saw how he fought, like the way he had a plan, it's fine. I would also like to come again and fight him, if he gave me a chance of fighting.
What gave you more problems against Zab? What gave you the most difficult, you know, what impressed you most about Zab?
No, it's a good move, his speed. Like, as I'm saying, like, he had a lot of experience. But that's one of the game, like, because I've never lost for a long time. I think that's the way, like, that's the name of the sport. You lose some, you win some. So I will come back again and fight.
How much? did your trainer arriving late, did that affect you a lot leading up to the fight?
No, we did have our homework there at home, so it didn't affect me anyhow because we had trained very hard for this fight, just one of those punches that caught me. So I didn't, even if he didn't came, I didn't have any problem because I'm with assistant trainer here, of course, we did our homework there back at home. So just those one of those punches that caught me.
Thank you.
Kaizer, rate his power versus other guys you've been in with.
Pardon?
Can you rate his power?
No, it didn't hit me because I didn't feel anything. But just, it was the punch that caught me out. But with the power, no, it was heavier than me.
I think Kaizer's trainer would like to speak as well.
Evening, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah, it was a great experience for Kaizer, you know, it's the second time in America. He's only 30, I see the press has got 32, he's 30 years old. Zab Judah is a great fighter, good experience. Kaizer had his opportunity, it didn't happen. You know, Kaizer hasn't fought for a year, so you can see he was a little bit interested. He battled in the first couple of rounds. But, you know, it was a great fight. Zab Judah did well. May he go on to do what he needs to do. And then maybe sometime Kaizer get another opportunity. He's only 30 years old, and it was great being in America. It's a pity we had a smaller hiccup to be coming late, but we're not looking for excuses. We had our opportunities, and God bless Zab Judah and his captain. And thanks to Main Events, Bronco, for giving us this opportunity, and hopefully we can do it again.